What's up, everybody? Crimson Raven here, and it is time for another daily challenge. But first things first, yesterday's run that I actually had to split in two for being so long landed me in the top 5 in the world. Holy shit. Yes, I got 4th place, so I am extremely happy with how that run went. And I'm hoping to have a lot more of these now. So, today, our run is with Leto the Cleric. And I think Leto's usually a character that I tend to, that tends to fit my playstyle fairly well. So, let's do this. Let's just get into it. Okay, what do we got? Archangel's Embrace. I haven't seen this weapon in very long. Small chance to freeze. I don't think I like that weapon all that much. Okay. So, what we get as Leto, an increased chance of getting nastier enemies, an increased chance of getting health potions. Health potions give me a ton of health, and that's it. Leto does have some pretty serious mana management problem, though. He is very hungry. Oh, okay, now I kind of remember. It does a lot of damage, but the trajectories are a freaking pain in the ass to deal with. And the wand actually has a freeze effect to it, which is great. I really don't like the spell I was dealt, though. If I have any occasion to switch it out, I probably will. Ow. Okay. That hurt. Kill the eyeball. Kill the eyeball fish. There we go. And eyeball fish. Again. Please die now. Ow. Bye. There we go. First room done. Any secrets whatsoever? I don't think so, unless maybe on that side. Nope, not gonna happen. Just because of how doors are placed. No, there's no secrets here. Okay. What do we have in here? Eyeballs. More eyeballs. And demons. I just saw the red projectile. Starting with demons already. Holy crap. Okay. The freeze effect is very, very useful here. This spell does do a lot of damage, though. I gotta give credit where it's due. I'm gonna increase my life pool. Okay. So, yeah, Leto is inherently very, very tanky. It's just that he does consume mana at the speed of light. Pretty much. Which is quite similar to the kind of build that we had yesterday for that incredible run.
So I'm not too concerned about it as long as I can play smart. I can two-shot slimes with this. Shoots through enemies. Oh, there we go. Just line it up, knock him down. Oh, that's an armored one. There we go. And you're gone. So if I make every shot count, this thing can actually be useful. And that's two health upgrades we've already taken on this run. Two health upgrades and three level ups.
Sure.
Bring on the health. I heal like 1,000 HP per health potion anyway. So why the hell not? So, these rooms are just minor annoyances, unless you run through them too fast. Okay. Armors. Easy armor. Kill these. How did it have any time to fire? I don't get that one. Come on. Freeze up. I really don't like the patterns and the trajectories from these things. Especially, I'm not gonna test it out, but if my memory serves me right, I do believe, that you can hurt yourself with the projectiles coming back at you. If I shoot from very close range, though, this weapon is not entirely useless. So, I can kind of adapt my playstyle to it, I guess. I just really don't like the sheer amount of risk that you have to take. So far, we've had it easy, though. Have Gunkar the Warlord. Again, I don't even have the key. So. Oh, I thought, yeah. I thought we were ready for the boss fight. I forgot that there were some more rooms. All the way over there. Why am I going around? That way. There. Across the bridge. Back in here. I haven't seen any secrets so far on this floor. There's the secret. Okay, so very little damage on the wand for our friend the cleric. I am getting back a small amount of mana at the beginning of each battle, which is incredible synergy here, because enemies are not going to be dropping a lot of mana crystals, especially as we get on lower floors, or higher floors, I don't know which way we're going, to be honest,
But as we get to more advanced floors, we're going to see less and less mana gems dropping. So that mana thirst that Leto is victim of is going to become even more of a pain in the ass. I'm going to stay like center. This thing does deal a whole lot of damage. I just... Wow. More health or Trickster? Might as well go full tank. At that point, why the hell not? More health. Already 175 HP. Weapon does plenty of damage. It's just a bit of a pain in the ass with the patterns. 132,000 points. I thought we had it easy. We actually did a pretty good score for a level 1. And what do we got? Arcane Storm. I am keeping that. I like the Arcane Storm a lot more than that other... I'm thinking Archangel's Embrace. I really don't like the Embrace. Really don't like the patterns that it has. It's kind of unpredictable. Painstorm is very predictable, on the other hand. You aim in the general direction of enemies and they get zapped. That's the gist of it, and I love it for that. You know, plain and simple. So... No secrets. I've been looking for secrets like 5 times already. Treasure room. We get a perk for it. Spell mastery. More arcane storm. Not complaining here. Not complaining at all. That is right where I want things to be. No hidden doors, so move on to the next. That's a fight. See? Aim, get zap. That's it. Burn through all of my mana for this, though. So maybe I should reconsider taking the embrace. Ow. That is a fast skull. Freaking green aura. There you go. Ow. It froze on it mid swing. Okay. So I'm guessing Arcane. Yeah, I was not completely aware of how much mana hungry Arcane Storm is, but I think I'm gonna switch back the weapon. I'm burning through my mana pool way too fast otherwise. And this thing just won't die because my wand doesn't do any damage whatsoever. Come on. Please die. Please die faster. This is taking forever. Yeah, just freeze him. That is taking forever. Whoa! There we go. And there's some blue mana and a score goblet.
and some health.
Okay.
Back over here we go. Next room. I'm going to switch back to the Embrace. Even though I don't like this weapon, it does use a lot less mana than the Arcane Storm. Especially against these dudes. If I shoot them from up close, I can actually do a fair amount of damage to them. And it can freeze demons. Learn a new spell. I've got nothing to lose here. What do we got? The Lidless Eye. Hell yeah. Keeping that. Switch. Freeze him. Yep, I'm a lot happier now. I am a lot happier now that I have the Lidless Eye. Okay, choking, bad idea. Come on, Raven. You know, breathing is usually a useful thing, at least. What do we have? Okay. Take care of the eyeballs first. Why are you not freezing? There you go. And dead eyeball. Well, I guess I did take a fair amount of damage. You're a speedy one, so you highly annoy me now. Yes, freeze. Freeze is good. Keep him frozen. I don't have any more blue mana for the Lidless Eye. Keep this guy back here. There we go. Now we can run. Grab all of that crap. So the eyes do a little bit less damage, but they allow me to switch to something else and keep firing. So it's basically, that is why I love the Lidless Eye, because it's basically allowing me to use two weapons at once. Now I can drop these. Let them shoot. Run around, drop another one, maybe two. All clear. Easy peasy. And I don't have to drop that many each shot uses a lot of mana, but I don't need to be dropping a ton of those. If I keep about two on at a time, should be more than enough. Do they shoot obelisks? Yes! So now I can just drop some of those. And then run. And then run. And just let the eyes do the job. Oh, that's a lot of damage. Run. I'm gonna go down there first. There we go. Nicely done. That's a lot of fire. Mana Burst! Oh. Oh, how tempting. So very, very nice, especially with the Lidless Eye. I've already got a ton of health. Yeah, I'm taking that. Let's do this. So now everything hits like a truck. Step number one, draw them back over here. As far away from the obelisk as I can make them. Ow. Please die. Thank you. Bring them all over here. Okay, now run. By the time they get back over here, I'll have done a lot of damage to this thing. Nicely done. Go back up here, drop one eyeball. Should start dealing a decent amount of damage fairly quickly. Unless it keeps missing, like that. Face. Oh, there we go. Back to full health. No mana. That's pretty much what I was expecting. But I'm doing so much damage now. Just can't ignore it. That's a boss fight, and that's gonna be Polico. Ooh. Maybe I should switch back my weapon. Because the pattern is actually going to be advantageous for me this time. Because the shaman spawns a ton of carrots. We got the key. No secrets here. We got a couple more rooms to the north. Let's go up north. If I have any form of mana regen, I'll be very, very happy. Alright, what do we have? Mushrooms. Run to the other end of the place for now. That's a secret room. I'm taking a fair amount of damage from these imps. But I figure the room's big enough for me to be able to kite around. Back to the other end, start shooting something, and then pick the XP, run back to the other end, drain it all the way back again. Oh, hi. That was fast. Double kill in one shot, sure. Just keep freezing these suckers. That's one of them dead. Oh. I really, really can't waste any shots like I just did. Okay, one more death. Come on. Did these even hit? Crap. Top missing. There we go. I saw a secret room right there. Inside we go. Staff affinity. That's very bad. I don't have a staff. Well, that's very, very, very bad. And I have no mana, and we're gonna fight Polico. That's even worse. Gonna have to be very careful with my shots. Because I'm gonna have some mana from Vigilance. Just level one. It's almost nothing. I had one shot. So start running. He dropped the blue. He dropped the blue. Run for the blue. Go back. Shoot the blue in his face. I think I wasted it. Okay, I'm gonna start running around a little bit wider here. Because I just need... Oh, crap, crap, crap. Okay. Did he drop anything? No, he didn't. He's about half health. And I'm getting very, very low. Keep running. Gotta go in very unpredictable patterns, otherwise. Crap! Oh shit. That's bad. That is very bad. Please die already! I'm like two shots away. I'm one shot away from dying. And I'm dead. So much potential wasted. But this is a run that you guys are going to be destroying my score. I guess karma does return sometimes. I had two very, very good runs for the last 2 days. So I was kind of expecting this one to go wrong in every possible way. And I should have gone for the safe choices. And I decided not to. Because, you know, no risk, no glory. Anyways, that is it for today's daily challenge. Thank you. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to leave your feedback in the comments below. And if you like the video, make sure to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. And as for me, I'm Crimson Raven, and I'll see you soon.